It's me, Myra, at Down Home Money, a simple approach to financial freedom. I hope you're doing well. It's Tuesday, it's my day, and I want to talk to you about faith over fear. A lot of people are fearful right now about what's going on in our country and in the housing market and in the stock market. And I just want to share with you some facts about the housing market and the facts about the stock market, and just share with you some things that might help you have faith instead of fear. All right, you ready to get started? Okay, so just so you know a little bit about the history of the housing market, and we'll just go to, first we'll start with, you know, the first crash that we all kind of know about that's in the 1900s. I mean, there were some in the 1800s also, but the first crash was, like 1929. You know, everybody thought of that as a stock market crash, but it actually had a housing crash also with it. And then in 1991, we had the savings and loan crisis. If you remember the savings and loan crisis, which caused some housing crisis. And then the big one, 08, 09, the housing crash that a lot of us are looking at and in fear, so to speak. That's kind of where it is. I mean, you see all these videos. Are we going to have a crash? Is the housing market going to crash? And honestly, I don't think the housing market's going to crash. I'll just say it right now, early on in the video for you. And the reason is I've been in the housing market for over 30 years. And I have a bird's eye view of market, of offices, real estate offices, and watching them and their financials and watching what's going on. And I can honestly tell you, I don't see it. Here's what I see. I see, yes, inventory is low. So whenever inventory is low, prices are high. That is life. Remember toilet paper, you guys? Oh my gosh. I mean, that is called supply and demand. So of course, housing is gonna be high. But here's the other thing, is that because of lumber went through the roof, that slowed that down, that slowed everything down too. And because of the pandemic and fear of losing your job, if I need to go on and buy the house now because I may lose my job and I won't be able to qualify for a house, I had a couple of those. I mean, there's been a lot of fear around the housing market and the stock market and what's going on. And so, but here's the thing. Every time we've had a crash and all these different things that have happened, what happens is our government sets up legislation to help prevent that from happening the next time. Like if you remember, the crisis in 08 was a lot brought on by the lenders. Lenders were going bankrupt. And so the government had to step in and help with all of that. We're not going to have that this time because they set regulation to prevent that. And so it's going to be a different kind of shift. I like to call it a correction. I do think prices are inflated right now, but who knows? Any price point is based on what a buyer is willing to pay. That's in anything that you buy. Now, if I'm looking at this house and I think this house is worth $500,000, but yet you're looking at this house and next door is one of your good friends, it's in the right school district, it has all the things that you've ever wanted in a house, you might think it's worth $525,000. So here's the moral of that story is that everything is worth what a buyer is willing to pay. Sellers right now are pricing things really high because they realize they can probably get it because when the demand's high and the inventory is low, you get to demand the price you want. So what's gonna happen, because I'm watching it, you guys, I'm seeing it, okay? Now, here's what happens. It's slowly, and then suddenly, we have a lot of houses on the market. So, I will tell you, it's already happening, and if you don't believe me, go to realtor.com, put your city that you're looking for a house in there so that they send you all the new listings, all the price reductions. I'm seeing several price reductions that I wasn't seeing. You know, 3 months ago, I wasn't seeing price reductions. Price reductions have started. I've been through this before. I'm already seeing the signs. I know what's coming up. It's not going to be a crash. It's going to be a correction. It's probably going to be a 5 to 10% correction. So if you're thinking about selling your house, get that house on the market now. Call a local realtor in your area. Get that house on the market. Because I'm telling you, in 6 months, 9 months, I don't know. I don't have a crystal ball. I don't know when it will actually finally just hit. But once it does, the market will correct itself. We're not going to have a crash. We're going to have a correction in the housing market. That's what's going to happen. So, and it depends on where you live. I haven't had huge increases in my area that I sell real estate in. So I'm not expecting maybe 10% correction in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. But I know that California and Florida in 06, by 08, the same house you would have bought in 06, as much as 50% less. Now that's scary. That's scary because if you want to move or you want to sell it, you had to have to bring money to the table. I was selling houses in 7, 8, 9, and people were bringing money to the table. Not a lot in my area, but I will tell you, I had several people bring $20,000, $30,000 just to get out of their house. And so what happens when they get so far upside down, like in Florida and California, is they let the house go back because they feel like they'll never be able to get back. Like if the house was, say they paid $1 million and now the house is worth $500,000 and their loan was $800,000, they put $200,000 of their own money in, they're still at a $300,000 deficit. So they couldn't sell their house, so they let it get foreclosed on. Hopefully we won't see that big of a change in pricing, but we're going to see a correction. It's inevitable. So get ready. If you're saving your money and you want to invest in real estate, I will tell you my best investments were in 9, 10, and 11. You know, the market really stayed down for several years. Once it goes down, like it goes up and it's only up for a year and a half, and it seems like, you know, if you really watch the graphs, I mean the highs at the peak, and then it goes, and then it stays down for a while before it starts going back up. I mean, it's like the bell curve, you know, it just happens like that. And but real estate has been my best investments, and matter of fact, I'm getting ready to sell a house that I paid $52,000 for. And I am going to sell it to another investor because I don't want to do any work on it. And I'm going to sell it for $150,000. So three times my money. I have had it for, 15 years at $1,000 a month rent. You can do the numbers. Made plenty of money on that property. Now I'm going to roll it into a newer property. And I'm going to hold the money first. And then I'll roll it to another property. So anyway, keep the faith. I'm just telling you that there are going to be some deals, and if you have struggled finding a property and you're a first-time home buyer, faith over fear. Don't be fearful. Your time's coming, and it's probably going to be a much better deal for you and your family. Remember, it's not how much money you make, it's how much money you keep, and are you buying assets that throw you off a passive income? We'll see you next Tuesday. Oh! Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up. See you next Tuesday.